Hello, this is Iriamote Island, one of the most southern islands of whole Japan, very close to Taiwan and even to Philippines. Today is May 21st, and this one of small places on the coast of Iriamote, not far away from caves with bats. And this is a forest, again not far away from the cave, and at first I will give you small exercise for plant identification. There is a very specific life form in tropical forest, which we call giant herbs. So giant herbs, somehow a bit like bananas. This is a one of elements which you see nearby. So for a giant herbs, yes, this is it. So this is a giant herb, and giant herbs mostly belongs to gingers. Gingers is not just one family of plants, but several small families. But ginger family, Zingiberaceae, is one of the biggest. So this definitely is a plant from a ginger family. And plant is likely alpinia. So alpinias are remarkably with the red fruits and terminal paniculate inflorescences. That particular species grows in Japan only on Iriamote, because this species was discovered from Philippines, but Philippines are purely tropical and this is almost tropical. So I'm staying about, well, 80 kilometers from North Tropic. So Philippine species here, this Alpinia labellata, is not a big surprise. So this is one of Alpinias, and I choose it because it's very nicely stained on the background of giant ficus and also ferns, and also give you some understanding of how gingers, plants with only one stamen, a very remarkable flower, how they are flowering. So flower of ginger is quite typical monocot flowers, and if you remember, you need to, well, kind of imagine the tulip. So tulip has six perianth members, three are outside and three are inside. In the same structure, essentially, is here. So there are three calyx lobes, kind of cupulate, and three green corolla-like lobes. But this is something strange, because there are some pinkish structures in the flower. They are staminodes. So three stamens are reduced, because two stamens start to be sterile, and they are actually function like an attractive organs, because corolla is green, so insects are attracted by staminodes. So there are only one stamen is developing in ginger, and this is so strong that it will take female organ with it, because actually the style, the place which will bear on the end the stigma, receptive part of female organ, receptive part of pistil, is so weak in gingers that the stamen will take the stigma upward and it will actually keep it in the upright position. It's quite visible here in the flower if you look on it closer. So this one stamen, that stamen will keep the style, and on the end of the style you will see the developing stigma. As I see here, at first structure is upright, but then structure is slightly curving, and the topmost part of the style will develop bigger and bigger stigma. So flowers which are older definitely are in female stage of flowering, so stigma is receptive. Nectar is typically laying in between filament, so between these two filaments, style and anther-filament, insect will search for nectar. And as you understand, it almost inevitably will touch either stigma to receive the pollen from their body to stigma, or anthers and take the pollen from anthers to their body of insects. So this is how pollination of ginger typically goes. Pollinated flowers will be converted, ripening into the fruits. So that plant is happens to have both fruits and flowers. So all of them are present today on May 21st on this plant. So again, this is the Iriamote forest. and one of the remarkable pieces of alpine, the only one place in Japan where you can see that, actually, largely Philippine species. Actually, Luzon, the northernmost Philippine island, is not so far away from here. So this is understandable. Thank you.